Hey guys, Mark here. Thanks for taking a few minutes out of your day to spend some time with me. I treasure your time, so I will do my best to keep this brief. I want to take a few minutes to talk about something really simple. This little guy right here. It's this little piece of cardboard. It's 2 inches by 3.5 inches, and it is absolutely loaded with potential. All kinds of things that can be done with it. This, of course, is a business card. The instant you break one of these out for somebody, you don't have to explain what it is. You don't have to explain what it's for. You don't have to explain its purpose. Everybody knows this is a tool for business. This is something that you use to promote a product, a service, what have you. Many of you have one of these, maybe more. A lot of you have these as performers, as magicians, as mentalists, what have you. And they're great. They're absolutely wonderful. But it's the very simplicity of what they are and what they are used for that makes them so incredibly powerful. And let me explain what I mean. Because with these little guys, as magicians, as mentalists, this can be so much more than just a tool, a tool to promote business, a tool to give to a potential client, somebody who's asking for information about you, whatever, on how they can be in touch with you. This can be so much more than that. As performers, we can use this as a tool for entertainment on the spot, making this potentially much more than just a business card. And the very fact that it is such a simple thing and that it is so common that everybody knows what it is, there is so much you can do with this that nobody has even the tiniest clue is even remotely possible, okay? And there have been, over the years, there have been a lot has been written about the use of business cards in magic and mentalism and so forth. I remember back when I first became seriously interested in these little guys, I had landed my first table hopping gig. I was doing strolling and table hopping at a country club. They had a restaurant and a lounge, and I was in there a couple nights a week entertaining the patrons. And suddenly, business cards became very important to me, because when you're right there, people, they ask for your card. If they're having a good time, if you're doing your job properly, they want your card. And we're talking, this is well over 35 years ago for me. Well, then, back in 1995, I created a little thing, this little guy right here. A lot of you know what I'm holding right now. This is called the Sight Unseen Case, or the SUC for short. And this little guy right here, it's a business card case. It's used to carry business cards, but it is also gaffed in a very unique way that allows you to do all kinds of nefarious things, all kinds of things. It allows a wonderful toolbox, if you will, to just have in your pocket. But it also allows you, in a very classy little package, to carry your business cards. Well, when I had this, and this is not what I'm here to talk about, when I got this, suddenly I had a tool that I could carry those business cards in that allowed me to do a ton of different things. But I thought, okay, I need to know everything that I can about this, the things that are going inside that business card case. And back in 1995, when the SUC came out, that's when my vested interest at that point in business cards really exploded. And in the years since then, my personal files on business card related material in mentalism and magic, everything to do with business cards, even what we do, my files have literally exploded. I mean, they are massive. They are unbelievably huge. And I'm not just saying that either. And over the years, like I mentioned, there's been a lot written about business cards and how we can use them. There are multiple books written specifically about business cards for magicians, business cards for mentalists, business cards for performers, for us. And some of them are really good. Some of them are very, very good. I was very lucky early on. I picked up one of the best ones early on that was available at the time anyway. There have been some really not so good ones as well. But I promise you, and this is the reason why I come to you today, I promise you, in the entire history of magic and mentalism, there has never been a book like this. This book right here, this is the Business Card Compendium. And lurking behind this very uncreative title, but completely accurate, is a ton of business card material. Regardless of what kind of performing you do, there is stuff in here for you. This book, and this is a book. This is not a booklet. It's not a pamphlet. This is a book. Let me give you just a hint of what all is in here. And this is just barely scratching the surface. There's material in here about secret markings. There's a huge chapter in here on secret markings, and scattered throughout the book are some others that are not in that particular section. There's an entire section in here on magic, mentalism, so forth, using just cards, just a small stack of your business cards, nothing else. Just your business cards, the way that they are used right now. There are chapters in here about special printing, about using secret writing, about using double blanks. There's a whole huge chapter in here of magic and mentalism that you can do using just your business cards and a pencil or a writing utensil of some sort. There's a huge chapter in here on business card magic, magic tricks that you can do that use your business card, okay? There is a hefty chapter in here on out to lunch, as well there should be. If you don't know what that is, when you read this, you will know all about it, believe me. There's a huge chapter in here on stacks of cards, using a stack of, you know, a dozen, 15, 20, whatever, of business cards. There's a lot of material there. There's an entire chapter in here. I hear all the time, I hear from guys who say, you know, I don't need business cards. I don't do shows. I'm not trying to make money by doing magic. I just do magic for my family and my friends, whatever. If you are one of these people, you do need a business card, and here's why. Not to promote business. You are missing out on a tool that can be used as a miracle. That doesn't, you don't have to explain what it is. It doesn't take up any room. You can throw two or three of these into your wallet, and you are armed with stuff that you can do, something that is completely normal. And that's the beauty of that. There's a whole section in here of using material that you don't even need cards for, okay? Using borrowed business cards. There's a lot of material in the literature dealing with that. There's a whole section in here on business card backs, material and things that you can put on the back of your business card that allow you to do all kinds of things. There's a chapter in here on business card gaffes, using business cards as secret weapons, something no one would ever even remotely think was possible. There's even a whole chapter in here on some spooky stuff, if you will, some more bizarre, dark uses for business cards. If you are a bizarrist, if you are a seance worker and so forth, there's a whole section in here for you and a whole lot more. This book, it's a brick, okay? I'm not going to kid you. This thing is a brick. It's heavy. Let me give you the stats. 450 pages. In those 450 pages, there are 250 individual citations dealing with all aspects of business cards. There are 25 sections in here, each one dealing with a separate aspect of business cards, 25 sections. There's a bibliography in here that represents, as of the time of this writing, that represents my personal files on business card material, and it has 1,200 entries in it. That is in here. This book, there has literally been nothing ever in the history of magic or mentalism that even remotely compares with what this book has right here. It is now available. You can get it directly from me. And if you've got any questions about it, feel free to drop me a note. But this is a book that truly, genuinely, this belongs on every magician's, every mentalist bookshelf. This is a book you will refer to over and over and over. And I got to say one more thing before I let you go. It has been said so many times, and some people I'm sure who say it are actually paying lip service, but it's true. If you buy a book, if you attend a lecture, if you go to a convention, and if you walk away from that book, that lecture, that convention, with just one item that you can really, really use, then you've gotten your money's worth. I honestly believe that's true, because it just is. If you get something that you can actually use, you've gotten your money's worth. I fail to see how anybody who spends any length of time with this book at all can fail to get something that they can use, if not multiple somethings that they can use. This is the Business Card Compendium. This has been over 35 years in the works, and it is finally available. Thank you so much for giving me a few minutes of your time. Feel free, check this out. Let me know how I can help you out. And everybody, have a great day. Thanks so much. Take care.